In this video, let's talk about the concept of complementary angles, and after that we will do the problems of 8.3 of NCERT textbook for class 10th. In this triangle, if you consider C as theta, then A must be 90 minus theta. Now if you write sine theta, it is perpendicular by hypotenuse, therefore AB by AC. Now, if you look at cos 90 minus theta, because for this 90 minus theta, base is B and hypotenuse is AC. If you closely watch these two, then we can write sin theta is equal to cos 90 minus theta. That means these two are complementary to each other. So sin 30 can be written as cos 60, because cos 90 minus 30, which is equal to 60. In fact, that is why it is named as complementary of sin. So sin theta and cos theta are complementary to each other. Similarly, we can observe the reverse also. Sin 90 minus theta is equal to perpendicular. For 90 minus theta, BC is perpendicular, BC by AC. And cos theta, for cos theta, this is the base, BC is the base by AC. So 90 minus theta is equal to cos theta, cos 90 minus theta is equal to sin theta. Similarly, we can find a relation between tan theta and complementary of tan theta, that is cotangent theta or cot theta simply. So tan theta can be written as cot 90 minus theta. You can write the relation tan theta is perpendicular by base and cot theta is base by perpendicular. And cot theta can also be written as tan 90 minus theta. Similarly, in the pair of secant and cosecant, secant theta is cosecant 90 minus theta, and cosecant theta is secant 90 minus theta. So secant and cosecant are complementary, tan theta and cotangent, that is cot theta, are complementary, and then sin theta and complementary of sin theta is only known as cosine, or simply in short cos theta. So based on these concepts, let us proceed to solve the 8.3 exercise of NCERT textbook 10. It's very easy to understand the concept of complementary. So here, the first one, sin 18, in this type of problems, either you can convert sin into cos or you can convert cos into sin. So let me convert sin 18 as cos 90 minus 18 divided by cos 72. Now the numerator is cos 72, the denominator is also cos 72, therefore it's going to be 1. Similarly, here I can write tan 26 as cot 90 minus 26 divided by cot 64, which is cot 64 by cot 64, which gives me 1. Now here in this third problem, cos 48, so that is 48, and sin 42 can be written as cos 90 minus 42. So this is cos 48 minus again cos 48, which is equal to 0. You can convert this cos 48 also as sin 42. In that way also we can get the same answer, which is 0. Then here cosecant 31 can be written as secant 90 minus 31 minus secant 59. This becomes secant 59 and the second term is also secant 59. Therefore, the answer is 0. Now, let's proceed to the second problem, which is again very easy if you know the complementary angles. Tan 48, tan 20, tan 42 and tan 67 is equal to 1. We have to prove. So, I can convert tan 48 as cot 90 minus 48. I can write tan 23 as cot 90 minus 23. I'll keep the remaining terms as it is. Now, here this becomes tan 45 42 and second term cot 67 tan 42 and tan 67. We know that cot and tan are reciprocal. Wherever cot theta into tan theta is there, it results 1. Cot theta, product of cot theta and tan theta is equal to 1 as they are reciprocals to each other. So here cot 42 and tan 42, that will be 1. And another pair, cot 67 and tan 67, that is also 1. So, 1 into 1, which will be finally 1. So, out of 4, we have converted 2 tan terms into cot terms. And after that, by using the property that tangent and cotangent are reciprocals to each other, to prove the result as 1. Now, in the second part of it, cos 38. So I can write cos 38 as sin 90 minus 38 and cos 52 I can write it as sin 90 minus 52 minus sin 38 and sin 52 as it is I have written. Now, this is going to be sine 52 degrees and sine 38 degrees minus sine 38 degrees and sine 52 degrees. As the first one and second one is same, the result will be 0. So, these are all very simple problems if you simply understand the concept of the complementary. So, here tan 2a is given as cot a minus 18 and 2a is an acute angle. Now I can write tan 2a as cot 90 minus 2a, which is equal to cot a minus 18. As the two angles are with cot only, I can easily write 90 minus 2a is equal to a minus 18, or by rearranging the terms, 3a, this 2a goes to that side and 18 comes to this side, it is 108. Therefore, a is equal to 36 degrees. Now, let's do the fourth one. So, in this fourth one also, I can write a as cot 90 minus a, which is given as cot b. So, by equating the two angles, 90 minus a is equal to b. Therefore, a plus b is equal to 90 degrees. Now, let's proceed to fifth one. Again, we use the same concept. Secant and cosecant are complementaries. Therefore, secant 4a can be written as cosecant minus 90 minus 4a is equal to cosecant a minus 20. Now we can compare 90 minus 4a as minus 20. So now by rearranging the terms, this 4a goes to that side, it becomes plus 4a, therefore 5a is equal to 110. 90 plus 20, therefore a is equal to 22 degrees. Now ABC are interior angles of a triangle. And show that sin B plus C by 2 is equal to cos A by 2. So when there are interior angles of triangle, immediately write the sum of the interior angles of triangle is 180 degrees. Now as we require B plus C, so keep C on left side and send this A to that side. Now B plus C by 2 is required, divide both sides by 2. So 180 minus A by 2, which gives us 90 minus A by 2. Now sin B plus C by 2 should be equal to sin 90 minus A by 2, therefore which is equal to cos A by 2, because we know sin and cos are complementary to each other. Now the last problem, express sin 67 plus cos 75. Express 67 plus cos 75 in terms of trigonometric ratios of angles between 0 and 45. Again we use the complementary property. So sin 67, I can write it cos 90 minus 67 plus cos 75, I can write it as sin 90 minus 75. So this is going to be cos 23 degrees plus this sin 15 degrees. This 23 and 15 are very well in the range of 0 and 45 degrees. So here only the secret is, wherever sin comes, you can write it as cos 90 minus theta. Wherever cos theta, if you want to change it, sin 90 minus theta. Similarly, cosecant theta can be written as secant 90 minus theta, or secant theta can be written as cosecant 90 minus theta. Tan 90 minus theta is equal to cot theta. Cot 90 minus theta is equal to tan theta. In the relation cot and tan, in addition to the complementary nature, they are reciprocals also. Therefore, tan theta into cot theta is also equal to 1. So these are the solutions for 8.3. In the next video, I'll talk about the trigonometric identities and followed by the problems of exercise 8.4. Don't forget to subscribe the channel.